Palestine.
Oh, no. That's real. Palestine. The state of Israel. It's real. I've seen it.
You've seen it?
It's something you won't believe. Sometimes I don't believe it myself. It was the last week of the war. We were herded out of the death camp. Everyone knew liberation was near. No one believed we'd make it. All of a sudden, the Nazi guards disappeared. Just vanished. None of us even saw them go. I ran into the trees. I heard the sound of a heavy engine. A rattling, like a big wagon. I hid behind a tree. I knew what it was, of course. A tank. And then I saw it. I was crazy with panic. I tried to jump up and run away, but I couldn't. I couldn't even look away. And then it veered off. And I saw painted on its side a huge Star of David. Later, I found out it was the only Israeli tank in the Allied army. There was just one, and I saw it. Been running after that tank ever since. Now, thanks to you, maybe...
No. But at least they lynched that horse thief. Thought for a while there the varmint would get away. Early start tomorrow. Must cross the border before dark. After we cross, do you plan to stay aboard or make off by yourselves?
We signed on for Paris, sir.
Won't be in Paris for weeks. On the other hand, you could fly to Tangier from Brussels. You'll be there in a day or two.
You really do hear everything on board this ship, don't you, Captain? You also know how we plan to cross?
Naturally. That is why you chose to inflict yourself on my barge. Who's your contact in Tangier?
We have none.
If your aim is to get that girl into Palestine, you've got to use your brains as well as your guts. I know a man there who might help you. A Dutchman. Klaas van der Pink used to skipper a barge out of Rotterdam. The police were after him, so he ran off to North Africa. He's a smuggler there now in a big way, including immigrants into Palestine. We correspond occasionally. You'd better get in touch with him. The Hotel Tarzan.
Here. Write it down.
And don't be misled by his exterior. Van der Pink may look mean, and he is mean. No heart of gold inside. But he may just help you if you pay him enough money. Tell him I sent you.
I'm very grateful to you, Captain Brandt.
You and this wife of yours, are you thinking of marrying her someday?
Nothing could be further from my thoughts.
You mean her thoughts, don't you? Anyway, if you do find yourself at the loose end afterward, get in touch with me through old Decoy at the exchange. I need a partner, and you seem less useless than most. You even have a few brains. Look how you cheated me out of my 400 guilders. By the way, how did you know what I was carrying in the X-hold?
I didn't.
It's time. You'd better get below. Call me when you're ready.
What's down there?
Captain Brandt's other cargo, furs for Paris. This is what they called an ex-barge during the resistance. Come on.
I won't go in there. Not again.
You mean not again?
They had a box like that at the camp. Punishment box. They used to nail.
Lisa, don't lose your nerve now.
Are you to tell me? No!
Forward with me.
All right, tie up.
You were informed you were carrying a married couple. A deckhand and a cook. Where are they?
Oh, those two. The devil must have sent them. Listen. Tell you, neighbor, I was shocked. Shocked. So I threw them both off the ship in Molyneux, and good riddance.
What's the matter with that dog?
Oh, rats. Rats. I fumigate every trip, but they come back. Copper, I'm shined.
Nothing up forward, sir. Nothing in the cargo hold. Take a good look at this man, Inspector. I thought I'd seen his ugly mug before. Hieronymus Brandt, arrested 3 times for smuggling.
I have lived a blameless life, Inspector. Besides, they couldn't prove anything. Now, if you've quite finished, I'd be grateful if you'd get your ugly mug off my ship.
I haven't started with you,
Sergeant. We're wasting time. The people we want are probably at Mullendorf.
Yours.
Come up now.
I'm sorry.
Listen.
Good luck, Inspector. Good luck, you stupid.